Hi guys, I want to use my MacBook on a larger screen for editing some of my vlogs. So I've gone to the Apple store in London and got myself a wireless keyboard, a magic trackpad, a HDMI cable to connect it to the larger screen, and a book arc, which is a vertical stand for the MacBook. In this video, I'm going to focus on the keyboard. I'm going to unbox it and then show you how to set it up. But I'll also upload videos for all of the other products. Okay, as you can see, the keyboard comes in the normal sleek Apple packaging. It cost me £59 from the Apple store. It's the same aluminium Bluetooth keyboard that's included with every new iMac. There are no cables, which is great, and it uses two AA batteries, which are supplied with it, but you can also get Apple rechargeable batteries and charger. The first thing you notice is it's incredibly thin, so it won't take up a great deal of space on your desk and it'll be easy to store. Okay, this is the power button here on the right hand side. If you press it down, the keyboard will power up. You'll see the green light on the top, and if you hold it down, it will switch off. The battery compartment is here on the left hand side, and I'll just use a penny to unscrew it, and it takes two AA batteries. Right, let's connect it to our MacBook. Okay, to set the keyboard up with the Mac, we need to go into System Preferences. First thing we need to do is make sure the keyboard's switched on and make sure Bluetooth is switched on the Mac. Bluetooth is already switched on, so it's found the keyboard. Now we can pair the keyboard from this menu, but we're going to go back into System Preferences and go into the Keyboard menu, where we can pair the keyboard with the Mac, and there are more advanced settings. So it's found the keyboard. We're now going to continue, and it will give us a code to enter to pair the two devices. Okay, there we go. We enter this code 623469 and then enter on the keyboard, and that will pair the two devices. Right, that's it. The keyboard's ready to use. You've got the prompt there to tell you it's connected. You can use the keyboard as it is, or in this menu you've got some more advanced settings where you can customize the keyboard just to your liking. Now the keyboard's paired with the Mac, in future, when you turn the keyboard on, you'll get this prompt saying it's connected, and when you switch the keyboard off, you'll get this prompt telling you that the keyboard has been switched off. Okay, thanks for watching guys. If you found this video useful or helpful, don't forget to click the thumbs up like button. You can also subscribe to our channel if you'd like to be the first to see our next film. And there are links below so you can follow what we're up to on your favourite form of social media.